Welcome to Dewitt Community Church on this Memorial Day weekend. We're glad that you have come to worship with us virtually as we're practicing the regulations of social distancing during the coronavirus pandemic. We will continue to worship this way until it's deemed safe to gather together in one another's presence. As a church community, we believe that God longs for community, both each of us with Him and us as a group of believers who meet regularly to support and encourage one another. In an attempt to maintain these communal relationships, we offer a number of opportunities throughout the week on our church Facebook page to participate in daily devotions, times of prayer, and music. A list of those offerings are available on the church website, www.dewittchurch.org. If you should need any assistance of any kind, please feel free to contact the church office or the pastor on call number that's also available on our website. And lastly, as we work as a ministry to support the congregation and grow in God's kingdom, we ask you to prayerfully lend your support financially through your tithes and your offerings to the church. Checks may be sent through the mail to the church office, or if you'd rather give to the church through electronic means, you may do so at give.dewittchurch.org. We thank you for your faithfulness and generosity in supporting the work of God's kingdom. Today, we will be talking about remembering. We remember our fallen heroes. We remember all of those who have paved a way for us in faith. We remember our brothers and sisters in this faith community who we long to see, and remember the faithfulness of God who gives us hope for the future. Normally, we take this time to greet one another, but since we cannot do so physically today, I encourage you to reach out to one another over the course of this week to let someone know you care for them. Or if you're watching with us live, please feel free to comment in the comment section, also to connect with one another during the service. This would be a great way to let one another know online that you're there and you care for them. So now let us turn our hearts and minds towards God as we participate in our opening hymn, Like a Glorious River.
Perfect peace over all victorious. Good morning. As we begin this time of worship, let's join together in our responsive psalm and chorus. You'll see the lyrics and the text at the bottom of your screen, and I encourage you to read and sing along with us. We'll sing God of Creation, All-Powerful. We'll sing verse 1 together this morning. Works, Lord. In wisdom you made them all. The earth is full of your creatures. All creatures look to you to give them their food at the proper time. When you open your hand, they are satisfied with good things. When you send your spirit, they are created, and you renew the face of the ground. Forever. May the Lord rejoice in his works. He who looks at the earth and it trembles, who touches the mountains and they smoke. I will sing to the Lord all my life. I will sing praise to my God as long as I live. May my meditation be pleasing to him as I rejoice in the Lord.
God of creation,
good morning. Would you join me in a time of prayer? Heavenly Father, we thank you for this beautiful day, for the warm sunshine on our faces, for the sense of warmth that it brings us in our hearts. Heavenly Father, we are especially thankful for the ability to honor and remember the men and women in our military who sacrificed their lives while in service. We ask that you hold and bless their families in your hearts today as they recall the fond memories of their loved ones. We also ask, Lord, that you be with the families of those who are currently serving in our military. Protect them, guide them, bring them home safely, Lord. Heavenly Father, we're still dealing with this pandemic, and it brings so much fear. It brings so much uncertainty. It brings a lot of heartache and hurt. And we ask, Lord, that you be with all of those impacted. We ask, Lord, that you heal those who have been sickened. We ask that you bring hope to those who've lost jobs. We ask that you bring strength to families who are dealing with new responsibilities. We ask, Lord, that you be with those who are juggling new responsibilities at work. We ask, Lord, that you be with all of us to give us more patience, more kindness, more understanding, because all of us come at this from different angles. Help us to remember, Lord, that you are in charge, that you are with us, and that you are guiding us. Heavenly Father, we know that we can't be together because right now it is the safest thing for all of us. But we know, Lord, at some time in the future we will be, and we look so forward to that day. And until that time, Lord, we ask that you particularly hold in the palm of your hand the members of our congregation who are on our prayer and care. We ask that you hold those who are sick, and we ask that you hold those who are celebrating wonderful births, and we ask that you hold those who are grieving, We ask that you give those peace and love. Lord, now we pray the prayer that you taught your disciples. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And Lord, now we bring our personal cares, our personal celebrations, and our personal concerns to you. Please hear us now. Lord God, we thank you so much for hearing us and being with us. We ask you to always walk alongside of us as you have promised. We're so thankful for your strength and for your love. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
We come into this time of worship, giving to God all the things that we have, all of our talents, all of our abilities, all of our financial resources. The gifts that we give are gifts that God has blessed us with. The gifts we give enable us here at Dewitt Community Church to do the work of ministry in our community and around the world. So we ask in this time that you prayerfully consider to give what is upon your heart, knowing that the gifts that you give are able to connect, to transform, and to change people's lives for the better. So today, as we give, may God's blessing be upon you and the gifts that we give. Let us pray. God, we offer these gifts to you as a way to do work of ministry, to serve our community. So God, we ask that you bless these gifts to make them fruitful and to multiply them. For your goodness and your grace, we ask all this in Christ's name. Amen. Thank you for giving.
Hi, boys and girls. Thank you for joining me today. I want to do a little experiment for a second. So if you can see me, I know I'm kind of short hiding behind this screen here, but I want you to hold out one of your hands like this. Hold out your palm, okay? And your other hand, I want you to pretend you have a magic marker in your hand because we don't want to write on our hands because that's not good. But what we want to do is pretend. So I want you to take your magic marker and pretend to write your name on your hand. So mine would say M-A-R-Y, and it would say Mary in big red letters on my marker. So think about that for a second. You might be thinking, okay, but what does this have to do with the Bible, Mary? And I'm going to tell you. So in the Bible, there's actually a section that says God wrote our names, all of our names, your mom, your dad, your sister, your name on his hand, and he knows all of us by name that way. Let me give you another example. Have you ever been to your grandparents' house or school or something, and you forgot something really, really important, like a book or maybe a stuffed animal or something really special to you? I have too. I think it's human. We do it all the time. But here's the really good news. God doesn't forget. He doesn't forget us at all. He knows all of us by our names and who we are as people. So I want you to remember something today. We are all God's children, your mom, your dad, your siblings, and you. And God doesn't forget us. Even when we might forget things sometimes, he is always with us. He loves us so much that he has a special place for us in his heart. So can I pray with you really quick? Okay, let's pray. Lord, thank you for always remembering us, even when we might feel forgotten. You are our Father in heaven and watch over us all through the day and the night. Help us to remember that you love each of us so dearly and that we are so special and each are remembered and loved by you. Amen. Thanks for joining me today, guys. Have a great day. Bye.
Deepens, Lord, with me above. On this Memorial Day weekend, we're going to be talking about remembering. And that's what our scripture this morning talks about. In the book of Isaiah, God is talking with Israel. Israel believes that they've been forgotten by God. And God reminds them that there was no way that he could forget them. So listen to these words that come from the book of Isaiah, chapter 49. This is what the Lord says. In the time of my favor, I will answer you, and in the day of salvation, I will help you. I will keep you and will make you to be a covenant for the people, to restore the land and to reassign its desolate inheritance, to say to the captives, come out, and to those in darkness, be free. They will feed beside the roads and find pastures on every barren hill. They will neither hunger nor thirst, nor will the desert heat or the sun beat down on them. He who has compassion on them will guide them and lead them beside springs of water. I will turn all my mountains into roads, and my highways will be raised up. See, they will come from afar, some from the north, some from the west, some from the region of Aswan. Shout for joy, you heavens. Rejoice, you earths. Burst into song, you mountains. For the Lord comforts his people and will have compassion on his afflicted ones. But Zion said, the Lord has forsaken me. The Lord has forgotten me. Can a mother forget the baby at her breast and have no compassion on the child she has born? Though she may forget, I will not forget you. See, I have engraved you on the palms of my hands. Your walls are ever before me. And this is the word of the Lord. We find ourselves at the beginning of yet another summer season with the celebration of Memorial Day. Yet, unlike the way we've celebrated this holiday in the past with parades that feature local high school marching bands and family picnics by the water's edge, this year we find ourselves in the midst of a pandemic, something never before experienced by any of us. Large social gatherings have been banned, and we are asked to wear masks in public if we are around other people. It surely doesn't feel like any Memorial Day that I can remember. And after all, isn't that what Memorial Day is? A day to remember? Having grown up under the watchful eye of my father, who himself was a veteran, Memorial Day always seemed more somber and solemn of a time of celebration. It was very apparent growing up that Memorial Day was a day of remembering. We were encouraged to remember those who were no longer with us, both those who had served our country, but also to remember those in our own family who had passed on. And for our family, it was an intentional and almost rhythmic way of remembering, fostered in my father by his parents, who then in turn fostered it in me. For our family, it was a tradition of remembering passed on over generations, beginning back in Europe and continuing as our family immigrated to the United States. We would go early in the morning on Memorial Day to the family cemetery plot and plant flowers in the urns on either side of the extended family headstones. My father would always tell us stories, one or two, about something he had done with one of his relatives, but if one of his parents, maybe one of his parents or even one of his aunts or uncles. Listening to him tell animated stories about them made me feel like I knew them myself, although many of them had passed on long before I was born. He would recount both humorous tales about an uncle who loaded kids into the back of his truck so that he could get them into the New York State Fair for free, or sometimes more serious stories about families relying on each other and relying on friends and neighbors in times of need. One of my favorite stories that my father told was about his father, Nicola, who was known on the north side of Syracuse as the Candy Man. Having immigrated when he was young with his wife and his young daughter in the 1920s, Nicola found work in the local candy factory after being sponsored by an older brother to come and move to Syracuse. Each day at the factory, my grandfather would pick up pieces of candy that were considered imperfect and stash them in his coat pocket to take home to all the kids in the neighborhood. They would all wait in the early afternoon and late or early evening when they saw him coming over the crest of the hill from a long day's work, and bunches of the neighborhood kids would run towards him awaiting the sweet treats that he had for them. My father recounted that he would put candy in one of his hands and put his hands behind his back. And when he put his fist forward, each child had to guess which hand had the candy in it. If they guessed right, they received the sweet treat. But if they guessed wrong, they would have to wait until it came back to their turn. And he wouldn't stop until each child received their treat. The funny thing is, the same game is one of my fondest memories of my own father, who passed out bubblegum to our team before each softball game. And then I, in turn, played the same game with my three daughters when they were little, and I remembered my father, who remembered his father when we played that game. My father would always say, "It's important to remember not only where you come from, but who you come from, because they are all part of your story." Remembering helps us to see how far we've come, to see the help we have received from others when we're in dire straits, to understand the faithfulness of those who have gone before us, as well as the faithfulness of God. My father was in no way an academic, much less a scholar, but his simple words of wisdom about the importance of remembering are shared far and wide by scholars and theologians alike. In fact, scientist James Clerk Maxwell, known for his numerous achievements in mathematical physics, made sure that when a new laboratory was erected at Cambridge University, the entrance to the building spoke about remembering the faithfulness of God. To this day, the building bears the words of Psalm 111:2, "The work of the Lord are great, sought out by all them that have pleasure within." Maxwell insisted that this verse of scripture be erected on the stone over the entrance of the building so that no one forgot and always remembered that their work and their story was part of God's greater plan. They were not to forget who they were and why they were there. And isn't that the whole idea of being able to remember? Remembering gives us hope for the future as we look back over the past. Remembering helps us to see that we do not go through this life as an island, but are fully affected by and dependent upon God and one another. If you look back over your own life, there are always those memories of times when you faced obstacles that seemed too large or circumstances that broke your heart that you saw no way to overcome at the time. And then somehow the right person came along to help you, or an unexpected opportunity arose that changed the course of your life. Some people would say that you caught a lucky break. But as people of faith, we know that there was nothing less than the hand of God. And as people of faith, we remember God's faithfulness has been part of our own stories over and over again. The idea of remembering is a central theme throughout the Old and New Testaments. In our human nature, we tend to want to get on with things, to move forward and not linger in the past. And I would say this is even more prevalent in our society today, with new technologies being developed faster than we can learn to use them. Progress has made us impatient and tends us to push forward rather than ever looking back. God knows how easy it is for our minds to move on to the next thing and to forget about all that has happened in our lives and made us who we are. Yet without remembering, we not only forget who we are, but we forget whose we are, leading to our tendency towards leaving God out of the equation. But it's not just our generation that easily forgets. It's been this way throughout human history. As Israel crossed into the Promised Land after escaping slavery and wandering in the desert for 40 years, they were told to remember all that God had done for them. Moses' farewell address to the people urges, "Don't forget what you've seen. Don't let those memories fade from your heart as long as you live. Teach all that you remember to your children and your children's children. And don't forget that the Lord has given all you have to you." In essence, God was telling his people that on a regular basis, they were to go back over the major victories in their life and remember God's hand at work. Developing a habit of remembering is essential to us being strengthened in our faith. As people of the Western world, this advice seems to fall short on our ears. We want to hear God tell the Israelites what to look out for in the future, or how they should prepare themselves for what's to come. But instead, God warns the people that the biggest danger that they will face is forgetting their story, who they are and whose they are. But Israel, God's chosen people, seem to forget this over and over again. In this morning's scriptures from Isaiah, we hear God's intentionally telling Israel, they're crying out to him because they believe that they've been forgotten about. But in actuality, it's Israel that's forgotten to remember God's faithfulness to them. God's people failed to do exactly what God had told them to do over and over again, to remember how he had taken care of them, how he had helped them overcome all the kinds of insurmountable obstacles. They failed to remember how he turned their mourning into dancing. Essentially, God was saying to them, when it looks impossible and you don't see a way to stay encouraged, the way to keep your hope up is just to remember what I've done for you. Here, God doesn't just tell the people to go back over their history to generations before who had told and retold the story of their victories found by God's mighty hand, but it goes even deeper, even more personal. God says, just like the mother that bore you, I could never forget you. And even if by chance she could forget you, I will not forget you, for your name is engraved on the palm of my hands. God is telling them to live with the expectancy that God will always be there, strengthening them, encouraging them, empowering them. For even though we all walk through the darkest valleys, because we live in a fallen world, we have God with us and our light as our light and our shield. Remembering God's faithfulness even when we're going through tough times like we are now experiencing in the midst of COVID-19. Even though you might not see a way out, God has a way. Instead of being discouraged or negative, why not come back to God and do what he continually challenges us all to do, to remember. Remember how he saw you through the breakup of your relationship. Remember how he healed your heart after you lost your loved one. Remember how he healed, restored, and helped you to overcome. Remember that your name is not only engraved on the hands of God, but etched into God's heart. Go back and remember the mercies of God. It is in this remembering that we honor God and give him his rightful place in our lives. The creator of the universe not only has his hands on us, but his name, but our names are written on the palms of his hands. We have a history with God. In knowing that God is faithful, we just waste our time and energy wallowing in the should-haves or the would-haves. Instead, if we remember things right, we should remember the times that God brought us through, all the things that we couldn't see a way through. The daily mercies he provides for us moment by moment. And don't ever lose the awe of remembering the faithfulness of God. God is saying to us today the same thing he said to Israel in their fear and despair. Just remember our history together and look forward to what lies ahead as we walk together. When God writes your name on his hands, he will never and can never forget you. He doesn't want you wallowing in fear or regret, but looking forward to his new mercies that happen every day. Instead of remembering your life as a living memorial, remember the instances when you have felt God's provision, protection, grace, and mercy. And don't just remember on days like Memorial Day, but make it a habit of every day spending some time dwelling on the blessings and not the lack. When we develop this habitual remembering of the blessings and the mercies of God, our personalities, our demeanor, our attitudes reflect God's glory in our lives and serve as a living advertisement of why living faith is important. We show others they too can weather the storms and by relying on God, and often those others are right near us in our own homes. I was taught to never forget God's goodness in my own family. Story after story were told and retold of how my people should have never overcome the difficulties they faced. And yet by God's grace, they did just that, overcome, and were abundantly blessed in the process. I was encouraged by my parents and from reading scriptures to not only remember, but to tell my children about the goodness of God. One summer afternoon when my daughters were little, I decided to play the candy game that my grandfather had done with the neighborhood children back in what they called the old neighborhood on the north side of Syracuse, which of course was the same game that my father had played with me and my softball team before each game. While the girls were outside playing with sidewalk chalk on the driveway, I snuck into the house and grabbed a few pieces of individually wrapped candy that I stuck in my back pocket. But before going outside, a little voice within me told me, write each girl's name on the inside of your hand so that they, when they play the game, they'll see their names on the inside inscribed on your palms. I came back outside and we played the game, and to their delight, they giggled when they saw their names on my hands. And I guess they might have seen it as one of those downfalls of having a pastor as a mother, but it was a teachable moment for me. To remind them that not only I love them, but that God loved them and that he had their names written on his hands too. Later that evening, I was with my youngest daughter in the bathtub while she was getting ready for bed, and she started to cry. I said, I couldn't see anything that was uncomfortable for her. She didn't have water in her eyes or soap, so I asked her, honey, what's wrong? And she said, Mommy, my name is washed off your hands. I don't want you to forget me. I laughed and snuggled her close and said, I will never be able to forget you. You're a part of me. And better yet, even more importantly, God will never forget you. Remember, your name is engraved on the palm of God's hands. As we go through these days where it seems like we are tossed to and fro, where we hear one heartbreaking story after another, let us always remember and never forget the depth of God's love for us. Let us likewise never forget that we carry with us the memories of all those who have gone before us in faith and are responsible to all those who come behind us to serve as those who reflect God's mercy. May we let our lives be a living memorial commemorating the faithfulness of God. Will you pray with me? Gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you for memories. We thank you for those who have gone before us in faith. We thank you for those who come behind us in faith. We ask you to bless all of us as we go through this difficult time and help us to continually keep you in front of us and remember your goodness. But more so, Lord, help us remember that we are etched on the palm of your hands, that you love us more than we can ever imagine, and that you will never forget us or leave us. Help us today to take that memory into our lives and when we go through difficult times, to cling closer to you each and every time. We pray all this in the name of Jesus, our Lord and Savior. Amen. on this Memorial Day weekend, let us never forget those who've gone before us, those who've given their lives for our country, those who've paved the way of faith, those who've led us in our families, and help us to be a remembrance of their legacy as we continually share our faith with all those we meet.